The name of our course is Sex from Molecules to Elephants. Elephants we have already seen and will see much more later on. Today we meet the molecules, DNA molecules. Our culture is based on the accumulation and transfer of information by oral and written language. A coding mechanism that transfers information from one generation to the next is the foundation not only of culture but of all other forms of life. We call this transfer of information heredity or genetics. The language of all living organisms on our planet is encoded by the same molecule, which is called DNA. Amazingly, all organisms not only use the same molecule, but also the same language. DNA is a very long linear molecule that consists of many subunits that are connected to each other. The DNA in each of our cells is composed of 3 billion subunits, reaching a length of 4 meters when spread out. All information required to build an organism is encoded in the order of these subunits. As far as we know, DNA is the most information-rich molecule in the universe, at least until we find some other forms of life. DNA is composed of 4 different subunits, A, C, G, and T. Like a language, that all its words are comprised of 4 letters, the words of this language of life are 3 letters long. Each one of these words is translated in the cell into one of the 20 basic subunits of proteins. Proteins build the body and perform in it all its essential functions. The size of proteins ranges from tens to tens of thousands of subunits. Each DNA molecule encodes many different proteins. Each of the segments of this molecule that encodes a protein is called a gene. There are also genes that are not encoding proteins and regions that regulate when and where genes will be expressed. Each and every one of our cells contains in its nucleus the same DNA and has all the information to build an entire human being. Our DNA is packaged in 23 different chromosomes. The number of chromosomes varies widely among different organisms, from a single chromosome in a certain ant species to 200 chromosomes in a certain butterfly. Most organisms have several tens of chromosomes. In fact, the number is not that important, as the same DNA can be packaged in a different number of chromosomes, much like a book that can be broken down into a different number of volumes. So sometimes, organisms with very similar DNA will have a different number of chromosomes. The entire set of chromosomes, which is, as said, present in every cell, is called the genome. Gametes, a special type of cells that will be discussed in depth in the next chapter, transfer the genome from one generation to the next by sexual reproduction. We are here at the genomic unit of the Life Science Institute of the Hebrew University. Genomics is the science that studies genomes by establishing their sequence and analyzing them by computational methods. We have here sophisticated machines that can establish the sequence of DNA molecules. Similar machines were used to sequence the entire human genome 15 years ago. Since then, technology made huge progress, and genomes that took years to sequence at huge cost are sequenced now in a matter of days for very little money. The genome of many humans were and are sequenced all the time to identify differences and find genes responsible for genetic diseases. The genome of hundreds of other species were also sequenced, enhancing our understanding of many aspects of biology. You might recall the 4 species of giraffes we mentioned in the previous chapter, identified by sequencing. Michal will now demonstrate how to prepare DNA from strawberries or other fruit.
We are going to extract strawberry DNA.
Michal is first meshing the strawberries in a Ziploc to disrupt their cells so that the DNA can get into the solution. She mixes half a teaspoon of salt and 2 spoons of liquid soap in half a glass of water and adds this solution to the crushed strawberries. The soap will dissolve the membranes of the cells and the nuclei. The salt will cause the DNA to separate from the proteins to whom it is bound. The DNA is now dissolved in this solution, which is also full of strawberry debris. Michal filters the solution to get rid of this debris and precipitates the DNA out of the solution by adding an equal volume of cold ethanol. You can see now 2 layers, a red one at the bottom with broken strawberry cells and a white one at the top with the DNA. Michal collects this DNA with a cotton swab. You're most welcome to try this yourself at home.